following emotion. Calls may be monitored or recorded for training and quality purposes. By continuing this call, you acknowledge that the call may be monitored or recorded.
Thank you for calling emotion. Our office is currently closed. Our office hours are Monday through Friday, 8:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Our after-hours remote service technicians are available from 5 p.m. to 12 a.m. Eastern, Monday through Friday, and 10 a.m.
Glasses back at it again. Choose the truth, Barry. Fuck all the bullshit. I'm putting my memoirs together because when I get ready to go in front of City Hall on Monday in January, I'm gonna have something to say to the people here in Houston, Texas before I leave Houston, Texas to go back to Louisiana because I know too much to not let them know what they did to me. It's priceless.
It was criminal. It was priceless, dude.
In the good and the bad. Because I'm in the middle, knowing better, with the Creator. Love you, love. So, by me knowing better and doing better and being able to articulate, to be able to explain, I'm going to be so happy to be in front of this male here to be able to explain to him how what his policeman did me. I almost remember the day that they did me this, but when his policeman assaulted me after I was filming a documentary on how racist the policy is at Walmart with the return, to the point where I wanted to prove the point to how racist they are and profiling people in wheelchairs when they come there shopping. I just wanted to get that out for people to see for themselves. And plus, I was bringing back Walmart a videotape that I had, that they had accidentally gave to me that was worth $65. I was bringing it back to them. So they tried to say that I stole the CD to watching the camera and realizing that I didn't. So then they had to choose on what charge it was gonna give me to put me in jail. This is some bullshit. So I just want you to hear this here right fast.
It's that time of year. We're buying gifts. So what should I give a person who might want to learn about liberty? How about a book? Here are six that expanded my brain. First, Road to Serfdom. In this book, Frederick Hayek explains why government intervention in the economy leads to serfdom. For writing that, Hayek was trashed.
Dismissed, ridiculed, and ignored. Yet, in the end, even defenders of socialism came to concede that he was right.
Government doesn't need to intervene, wrote Hayek, because a free market, like a school of fish or a flock of birds, creates a spontaneous order. No central planner can allocate resources as well as the individual birds or people.
The economy's up.
Recently, an economist made this rap video about Hayek's ideas.
We don't need a mechanic. Put away the wrenches. The economy's organic.
But now socialism's popular again. And celebrities say things like this.
And we have to say yes to socialism, to the word and everything.
So A Road to Serfdom is a great book to give to your socialist friends, if only they'd read this. Still, its old-fashioned language can be tough going. Here's a gift that explains economics in modern language. In his many books, Thomas Sowell makes economics simpler.
No charts, no equations, all words. Plain English.
No graphs.
In basic economics, he explains things like why President Trump is wrong about trade.
How much should people really worry about the balance of trade?
Somewhat less than you worry about being struck by lightning.
Maybe someone will give this to the president? An even simpler book that tells the story of how a clueless lefty reporter finally woke up to the benefits of free markets is this book. But it would be self-serving of me to promote Give Me a Break, so I won't mention it. Atlas Shrugged is another great introduction to creeping government intervention. In this novel, Ayn Rand predicted today's America, predicted high society parties where rich people would vilify profits and other things that made them rich.
Our ideals are higher than profit.
Rand saw, long before I did, how that kind of ignorance and the size of government would increase, despite her character's efforts to fight it.
If you believe you may seize my property simply because you need it, well, then so does any burglar.
Nah, right there. Believe. TV pushes. Believe. Belief. Believe. Have faith. Believe. Understand. Believe. Have faith. Understand. And believe that this God character is only talking to the preacher, to keeping the congregation under the spell of the government, being a God that's teaching the preacher to keep you stuck on stupid and make believe la la land. With all that there is to be is within you to know better, to be the winner that you was born to be, knowing that you was already born a winner. Why run a race when you already won by the one that created the race in the first place? Come on, people. We're better than this. We know better than this. Naturally, we know better than this. But you've been taught to be stuck on stupid. Let's finish.
Government's the burglar, said Rand. And this book, The Myth of the Robber Barons, takes the point further. It explains why capitalists like John D. Rockefeller, people who were called robber barons, were in fact not robbers or barons. They were not born rich, and they didn't get rich by robbing people. They got rich by creating better things.
Rockefeller's affordable kerosene, processed crude oil, made the world brighter, warmer, cleaner.
Likewise, Cornelius Vanderbilt got rich not by robbing, but by making travel faster and cheaper.
Vanderbilt cut the costs of travel, filled his ships with eager passengers.
It was Vanderbilt's competitors who called him a robber baron, and the ignorant media picked that up. The competitors who hated Vanderbilt didn't feel much need to improve because they were backed by politicians. When they failed, there was always another politician to appeal to.
Vanderbilt, in contrast, had to serve his customers, or he would have lost his company.
Exactly, because the so-called robber barons had their own money at stake, so they spent it carefully. Two more books left. Consider Animal Farm. Novelist George Orwell describes farm animals who revolt against their human master, only to be ruled by new tyrants, the pig.
I'll make your decisions!
In Orwell's book,
the pigs.
Finally, another great introduction to freedom is this book, Free to Choose. Milton and Rose Friedman explain in plain English here how limiting government creates prosperity.
The free market enables people to go into any industry they want.
The Nobel Prize-winning economist once said, put the federal government in charge of the Sahara Desert, in 5 years there'd be a shortage of sand.
We somehow or other have to find a way to prevent government from continuing to grow and continuing to take over more and more control over our lives.
Well, we failed at that. But here at Stossel TV, we won't quit trying. And these books will help. Happy holidays.
And as long as you're trying, you'll never fail. I thank you for that, dear homie. That's some good shit. Love y'all all. And all is the love that's already in you. It's unconditional. It's the power you can't see or control. But it is all that there is to know.
See straight.
That every day thinking, you wanting to know more. Creativity is your third eye already ready in you. It's that unconditional love that beats your heart for you. It's people lie. The numbers don't. And you can do the at. You can do the math. Just add it all up to realizing it's all within you. The circle of life, and naturally we will select. Naturally, we were selected by the creator of everything to be here right now, consciously thinking and creating. I love you more than you love you if you don't know the truth that's already within you. I got you. All love. It is light as a feather to love for free when you know where the love is coming from with no material motive. It's in you and me to love with. It's what keeps us all going. It's what keeps us all together.
Yeah, people. Time for us to stop bullshitting. Time for us to wake up to what's really real. And I find, see, right here, for instance.
Staff infections and all the stuff that people catching in the emergency room in the hospital. Santa myself. What do I do?
So now they're saying you are not in bad stuff with it. I'm so wrong. I know one thing. If you do kill, well, if the other people don't kill, we are already going.
Like I said again, people, I got too much evidence to what I've been through to be able to articulate to anybody what I've been through if they just want to sit down and listen. And that's the thing. No one really wants to sit down and listen to what people really have to say because it's all about the dollar. And that's basically what y'all chase. Y'all chasing it heavily, and that's stupid. That's real stupid. So, I'm just saying, I'm not stupid. And I can explain how much I'm not stupid and can never be stupid again. Because one thing about the creator of all this, and me to have a heartbeat, would never want me to be fucking stupid. And when I say fucking stupid, I can say fucking stupid. Because I'm a grown fucking man. And I'm responsible for what I say, what I do, 24 fucking hours a day. That's why I say people lie, the numbers don't, and I can do the math for you. So it'll add up for you to see for yourself and realize for yourself, how much the truth is already ready within you. You don't want to know, I can't make you, period. But I sure can tell you, from there it's on you. look.
Exclusive NYPD cop seen on surveillance video.